We're going to learn about prefixes and suffixes, which are together called affixes. Prefixes and suffixes are known as affixes. The original word before you add the affixes is known as a root word. It can stand on its own as a complete word. So together, prefixes and suffixes are called affixes. Now the word which is there before you add a prefix or a suffix is known as a root word. And that root word is a complete word which is can stand on its own. For example, the word reform, re is the prefix and form is the root word. Here we have read and we have the word unreadable. So we have the affixes here, un as the prefix and able as the suffix. What are prefixes? You can see re, un, dis, all added to the word before the word, in front of the word. Okay. So, a prefix is added to the beginning of a word to make a new word. So, a prefix is a group of letters placed before the root of a verb. For example, the word unhappy. The word un means not, which is a prefix, and the root word is happy. Okay, now prefix makes opposites or antonyms. For example, happy becomes unhappy. Satisfied becomes dissatisfied. Okay. Now, this is the table of prefixes, their meanings, and an example of each. For example, the first anti. Anti meaning against. Antiseptic. Against septic. Okay. Very common prefix dis. Dis makes the opposite of agree becomes disagree. Ex means out of or from, export. Okay. Or ex-wife. In again makes an opposite. Dependent will become independent. Or inter, that is between, national now becomes international. Miss again used to make the opposite. Fortune will become misfortune. Multi meaning many. Colored becomes multicolored. Okay. So the ones used to make opposites are dis, in, miss, non, like non-fiction and fiction, okay, and un, okay. Pleasant becomes unpleasant. And the other ones are used before the root word. Next come the suffixes. A suffix is added to the end of the word to make a new word. Like common suffixes are full, that means full of, beautiful, plentiful, and without, meaning less, careless. A suffix is a group of letters placed after the root of a verb. Again, this changes the meaning of the word. For example, repentant. Now the root word is repent. And we add ant as the suffix. Okay, so you see suffixes here. Suffixes that make nouns. All these suffixes which help you to change the word and make it into a noun. Okay, like for age, a result, wreckage. Okay, ANC is added as an action. Importance. Okay. Assistant. That is the person. Yeah. Refer, referee. So adding EE. Okay. Again for ER or OR, a person. Teacher. Conductor. So teach will become teacher. Conduct will become conductor. Bake will become baker. Okay. Then ESS to make the feminine form. So when you have a male, to make it female, we use ESS, like waitress. Okay. Full, F-U-L. Spoonful, plentiful. Okay. Then IST, a person, again, florist. Okay. Chemist. Okay. Then we come to suffixes that make adjectives. These are the suffixes: able, en, ful, ible. So able to be, inflatable, woolen, beautiful. These are all, you know, describing words which are made by adding suffixes. And suffixes that make adverbs, most common suffix for adverbs is ly. You know, when you see a word ending with ly, we know mostly that they are adverbs, no? So they show you the manner of how things are done. Quickly, immediately, WARD shows direction, forward, backward, upward, and ways shows direction again, sideways, etc. So this is a ready reckoner for you. At any time you want to know how to use these, which is the correct suffix to be used, you can look at this table. So, some of the rules to be used while using or adding the suffix. Double the consonant. Now, consonant is any letter of the alphabet which is not a vowel. So, when you have words like hit and hitting, so the T is doubled. Begin, N is doubled. So we make, you add suffixes like that. Drop the final E. So when you have words like flexible and right, this E will be cancelled. Okay. And we add ILITY or ING. Keep the final E. There are some words where we don't drop, we leave the E. And just add the suffix like ment, measure becoming measurement. Then keep the y. For example, y, it just goes on and you add ed. Okay, enjoy, enjoyed. Okay, we have changed the y to an I. Okay, and then add ly. For example, this Y of happy and the Y of cozy gets cancelled. Okay, it gets cancelled and then you add your IL and then the Y. Adding IL and then the Y. So these are some rules which can ensure that you are writing the suffix correctly. The suffixes IBLE and ABLE. Here are some of sentences and some ways in which you can use those two suffixes.